Hi, some friends have asked me to show them how to make a pancetta. This is a dry cured pork belly joint with salt and flavourings. So I thought I'd put this video together to show how it's done. There are several stages to this and I will show it over a period of time. And it's firstly preparing the meat, which we'll do fairly soon, which involves boning and skinning the joint. Next, I'm going to show you to prepare the cure. You can do all sorts of different flavours with this, so there's no real problems with that. Then what we do is the curing process. I'm not going to do any filming of that because that will be just sitting in a fridge somewhere for a few days. Then I'm going to show you how to prepare that joint and tie it and dry it. And then what we're going to do is probably have a bit of film eating it. Unfortunately, you're not going to get all the flavourings coming across, all the lovely smells. But anyway, what we'll do is we'll get on and do that right now. So what we have here is a piece of belly pork. It still has some rib bones in it as you're going down here. I would suggest, unless you're very familiar with this, is to get this done by the butcher. It's a lot easier and cheaper. And it's certainly an awful lot quicker. And the other side, you can probably see from this along the edge that I have a good amount of meat here as opposed to fat, and that's going to be a really nice eating pancetta. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get in there. I'm not going to show you how to take these bones out. It's fairly straightforward, but the one thing you really must have is an extraordinarily sharp knife. But all I'm going to do is get on taking these bones out, and then I'll join you back in a second. So as I said, I'd be back with you in just a moment. So what I've actually taken away, I think you can see here, is I've taken that one piece out like that. I keep them fairly big and keep some meat with them because I'm going to use them as spare ribs. You can take them out individually and leave the little pieces of meat in between the bones and leave that with the pancetta. I prefer to take them out as one big piece. So what I do is I just get underneath and fold it back and take the meat away, cut it, and it comes out in a big piece, and then I use that as a spare rib. You can obviously always just throw these bits into the freezer and use when they're convenient, so that's how I do it. So you end up with a very nice piece of meat left here with very few flaps. You don't really want flaps when you're curing meat, because flaps are always somewhere where, if you do outside dry curing, and I'm not going to go into the whys and wherefores of that at the moment, everything you do here is at your own risk. I would just say keep all your meat refrigerated until you really know what you're doing. So that's how I leave it. Leave it like that. And then what I've got to do is to actually skin it. So we have quite a large piece here. This I never seem to be able to get very well. Again, with a butcher you can always do this, but basically, again, very sharp knife. You get in underneath here and then you try to leave as much fat with the meat and as little as possible with the skin. And that's really all you're attempting to do here. You just have to keep at it. It's quite a long process. And once again, I'll come back to you. So, as I said, I started it off by just cutting in here. I'm making it look very simple now, but the idea is you just keep putting it back and pull the skin off until you get right to the end. So then you end up with a piece of skin like that. And that again, I freeze up and use that. I sometimes lay that over some other meat and then get a lovely piece of crackling and do that. So that will all go in the freezer and I'll deal with that another time. So what we have here now is a piece of meat which we're going to end up turning into a pancetta, which means curing it. And what I'm going to show you next is how to mix up the cure, and then we'll come back to this piece of meat and show you what we do with it. Okay. So as I said, I was going to go through the cure mix which we have. Basically what I do is I've taken this meat and I've cut it into half now. The whole piece was about 2.4 kilos. And then what I do is I have a little spreadsheet which I just put it all into. But basically, if you're working on 1.2 kilos, which each piece of these meats are, then I use 25 grams thereabouts of sugar. That will be molasses sugar. Then I use about 25 grams of salt. So that's normal table salt. If you can get pure vacuum dried salt, that's all the better. You can look that up on the web. I use some pepper, which is whole peppercorns, which I then put into a mixer and give it a good old mixer. So I've got it all in there. I use about 10 grams of juniper. Then I also put in some nutmeg, which is about 2 grams or so of nutmeg. And then I put about 4 or 5 bay leaves, and I put 2 or 3 cloves. So just to run through that again, I have sugar at 25 grams, salt at 25 grams, peppercorns, black peppercorns at about 10 grams. You can put much more if you want to. You could quite easily go up to 20 grams if you really like it quite peppery. And then juniper, I put in about 10 grams. Nutmeg, I put in about 2 grams. Bay leaves, about 5 bay leaves. And then also the final one, which I put in, are 2, 3, 4 cloves, something like that. Okay? Then I whiz it all up as I demonstrated here. That's just the flavourings. I put this and I mix this with the salt and sugar. Then what I'll be doing is preparing the meat with that cure, and I'll just go through that in a second.